one I'm watching most closely these days is one that I'm involved in as the national principal investigator. So I'm involved in the trial of stereotactic laser ablation for mesial temporal sclerosis. So we're very eager to see what the efficacy and side effect profile is of that procedure and how it will compare with anterior temporal lobectomy, because it's an exciting method, which is far less invasive than open surgery for treating refractory mesial temporal lobe epilepsy. What we need to learn is how well it works, how often it works, and whether the adverse effects profile, the adverse effects profile, is similar or different to that of temporal lobectomy, particularly with regard to memory and language. I look most forward to the development of biomarkers to predict response to treatment. I think the biggest gap that we have in epilepsy right now is that we put someone on medicine with no notion of whether it's going to work or not. For that matter, we operate on people if they've not been responsive to medication. And again, we have a good idea that they're likely to respond, but we don't know who will fully respond and who will not. So if we can develop good biomarkers to predict in advance who will respond to a particular drug, who will respond to a particular procedure, I think that would be an enormous improvement in our ability to treat. I think genetics are getting more attention. We're learning a lot more about the contribution of genes to susceptibility for epilepsy. And as we learn more, it will help, I hope, inform our treatments, and we'll be able to develop new methods of treating people based upon specific genetic defects.